probably 40% of our business is coming outside UAE. We are in different part of the world, you know, as you said, from Australia all the way to Papua New Guinea, and you know, so it provide a good opportunity, but at the same time bring a lot of challenge because of the logistic which comes with it. This is part of the portfolio which we are trying to build, to have a kind of a mixed portfolio where we do not just count on one business or one region. And what we're trying to do is, you know, to have to complement our core business, which is the helicopter, with fixed wing operation, with investments in different sectors. For example, we are seeking a kind of a JV with Augusta in the region. We are working with in a simulator center with Mubadala. All of this is to have to end up with a mixed portfolio. So I think, you know, as much as we could and as much as we can secure a secured investment, we will keep pursuing those opportunities inside and outside UAE. Demand for helicopter in general is still, you know, showing a good demand worldwide. I think the type of helicopters changing, moving from medium, short range to you know, a longer range helicopter, which carry a different capacity in different part of the world. If we take Brazil as an example, the drilling has moved from the shore to really deep water, and for to be able to provide the logistic for those platforms, you would need a different type of helicopter. So it's still within the helicopter business, but it's different type of requirements. I think everybody was affected. It's something that nobody was able to escape. The only thing with the approach that we have followed, at least for the entities which we are managing, is to try to be as conservative as we could. And as long as you are covering your liabilities and able to sustain a kind of a downturn in the market, I think anybody who have built those strategy and the risk management within you know, the overall strategy of the company have managed to you know, escape. As far as we're concerned, we operate on contractual basis. Most of our contract is 2 years, at least in Abu Dhabi Aviation, so we were okay. I have seen difficulty within the executive jet market, charter business. They have suffered the most, but from what I have seen recently, it's, you know, they're recovered. I would say 90% recovery has been achieved. When we look at what drive those changes, it is the technology. If we look probably 10 years back, the maximum flight you could do probably 8-10 hours. Now with all the modern aircraft, this has been extended to 14, 15, 17, and, you know. So basically what will happen is linking the East with the West in a way that the new technology is offering provide Abu Dhabi with an opportunity, because, you know, flying from Japan or from you know, Malaysia or China, coming this way and then trying to connect to Europe and US, put Abu Dhabi in an excellent position, geographical position. And I think the success has been demonstrated by Dubai as well, as far as the location is concerned. And also with what you have seen, although a lot of people have seen it as a risk having so many operators in one region, but it kind of have another commercial advantage where, you know, it provide the passenger with the opportunity to, you know, get a connection to go anywhere in the world within, you know, a few miles, you know, 30 minutes, which is, I cannot recall anywhere in the world you can get this advantage, even in Europe, where, you know, so between here, Qatar, Abu Dhabi, I think there is this triangle of aviation, which will, I think, provide new opportunities for the whole world. Abu Dhabi provide a secure environment for investments. Most of the businesses in Abu Dhabi have an outreach to different countries within the region. So anybody who are interested or who is interested to invest in Abu Dhabi will have this opportunity, especially when we talk about business which require moving people, moving cargo in and out. This is one of the main advantage that Abu Dhabi will have, especially with the great support in the aviation business. It has very supportive leadership, trying to work and support the investors, trying to put a long-term strategy that will look at Abu Dhabi in the next 30 years. So all of this will contribute to having a kind of a secure investment, clear, transparent dealing with Abu Dhabi entities and all the government entities being prepared and re-engineered in a way to cater for all those additional investments that might come. The government have been working very hard to establish the infrastructure required to achieve those growth. As far as Abu Dhabi Aviation is concerned, we are seeking opportunity inside Abu Dhabi, and we have 30 years of experience in the oil industry. We have logged over 1 million hours in helicopter, flying helicopter. So all of this could be really leveraged to do any kind of JVs, investments, partnership. And I think the opportunity is there.